Hi everyone, this is Brandon here and we are back to our next episode of the Sherbet Challenge. So in this episode, we got 220 housing space available. So the first one was given by Tim First, and he asked me to use 2 witches, 3 valkyries, 30 archers, 30 barbarians, 30 goblins, 11 wall breakers, 6 giants, 6 balloons, and he hoped that he did the math right. So yeah, you got it right, Tim. 220 slots, I counted it out. And also asking me to use only lightning spells. However, you stated on the top that I shouldn't use my heroes. So I decided to go with not using any of my heroes. Although actually I was allowed to use one. However, I do think that it's fair enough for me to use the spells that I want to use. So I decided to bring some rich spells with me. So with this combo itself, I was able to bring like 4 spells. So eventually I brought 3 rich spells and 2 free spells. So as you can see, I decided to attack the base from a different manner, deploying and taking out the 2 wizard towers on the bottom left and the top right first. So eventually just breaking the wall on the top, and then now deploying some wall breakers to try to detonate that giant bomb over there, because we know that there are giant bombs from all the past few Sherbet Towers attacks that I've been doing. And then deploying some giants first to tank some of the damage, eventually deploying my CC which contain P.E.K.K.A. And then the witches has also come out to support, just spamming goblins so that they actually distract some of the structures. And then after that, just freezing up over there, taking out some of the other buildings too. Dropping my second rage spell soon. So as you can see, I've been able to use 4 spells to be honest with this combo. So it's not too difficult, especially with so many spells to use. However, of course, I decided not to use either of the heroes because I have enough spells to take out this base. And also, I tried to do it in a different manner. I actually scout the base for quite a while, maybe around 2 minutes, thinking of how to improve my strategy so that I could do this better. Because eventually, once I reach to like 180 or whatsoever housing space, it's going to be very difficult. So if you saw the first few episodes, I didn't do that well, to be honest, because with 240 or 230 troops, but I did that badly, it's not very nice. So I was trying to tweak my strategy around, and eventually for all these raids in this particular episode alone, I managed to do everything all on the first try. And of course, scouting and studying the base using the particular troops that I've been given is really important, especially even if you are doing it for, say, for example, clan war. It's really important to study and scout the base before you actually go for it, so that you'll be able to use your troops wisely and properly, and then eventually probably even 3-star the base, especially those people who are really hardcore in war, clan war itself. It's really important to scout your opponent's base first, making sure that you do not go the wrong direction. For me, I feel that direction is really important. Otherwise, you won't be able to score the 2 or 3 stars. So the next challenge was submitted by LeBron Doy. He asked me to use 1 golem, 1 lava hound, 30 goblins, 30 barbarians, 2 healers, 2 witches, 15 wall breakers, 2 giants, and 4 minions. In my clan caster to ask me to use 30 archers and 1 hawk rider. So to be honest, the hardest part would be the clan castle, because the clan castle is slightly tricky. You cannot deploy it at where a wizard tower is at. Once you do that, the 30 archers come out and they will just get fried by the wizard towers alone. So that's something I had to take in mind. So in order to use the clan castle, is either I have to use it with all my group of troops, or I have to use it in such a way whereby I use 1 giant or whatsoever to tank the damage off from the wizard tower alone. Then I can deploy my archers to try to take out the wizard tower without that giant being taken out. Otherwise, a wizard tower will actually one shot or maybe even 2 shots the archer tower. I'm not really sure about the damage from this level of a wizard tower. So just deploying my troops in this particular manner, I decided to drop the CC on the top left instead of going for the wizard tower, so that my archers can actually survive and be conserved till the end of the battle. And then eventually dropping some healers to try to heal the golem itself, because the golem was going down quickly, especially from the single targeting defenses such as the archer tower and also the teslas and even the cannons. So just dropping the rest of the troops, the wall breakers, healers at the back on the top left, healing that one single witch over there. Lava hound is tanking a lot of the damage off the air defenses. Then after that, just doing more damage to the wizard tower alone. Lava hound damage ain't really high, however the HP is super high. High to the extent whereby it's even higher than golem. However, when they split apart, the total damage from the pups, I do not think that it exceeds the golemite, but the damage is higher than the golemite itself. And also taken into consideration that air defenses do really high damage, so lava hound should have high HP hit points so that they can actually tank the damage of those air defenses, especially when there are so many air defenses on this particular base itself. There are actually 6 air defenses compared to like a normal base whereby you can only have a maximum of 4. However, if the base has like a single targeting Inferno Tower, it's not too difficult to tackle that, because if you have free spell, you can just freeze the Inferno Tower so that they do not do the maximum damage to your Lava Hound. So I'm planning to do like a small little mini tutorial on defenses alone, so that you guys can get a hang of how a certain type of defense is strong or weak against a certain type of troop. So I might do that soon. So hopefully you guys can stay tuned and watch that soon in a few more my next few videos. So yeah, just carry on the raid. As you can see, the minions have slightly almost gone down from all the damage from the wizard towers. But not to worry, there's actually a witch over there with a lot of skeletons and the lava hound still alive. Lava hound won't be attacked by the mortar, scoring us the 3 stars. Lava hound still alive. So yeah, the next one was submitted by Nasu. Nasu actually asked me to use 1 dragon, 1 lava hound, 1 golem, 2 healers, 2 witches, 30 goblins, 5 giants, 29 archers. However, he didn't calculate it correctly, so I was left with only 216 slots to use. So I decided to add 2 wall breakers to my army combo. So adding 2 more wall breakers was pretty nice. It essentially helps to break through the wall. If I didn't have the wall breaker, I couldn't break through the wall that easily. However, not having wall breakers, of course there are ways to counter the wall issue, such as either using a jump spell. If there's no spell, you just have to use some of your troops to try to break through the wall, using some other troops to try to tank off the damage. So that's something to note for if you guys are actually using like a golem and wizard. The golem basically tank the damage off the splash damage, such as the wizard towers or even the mortars. And then after that, the wizards are just behind supporting and then just dealing damage over the walls. So same as barbarian and archers, whereby the barbarians will tank the damage off the archers, just shooting over the wall and taking out that particular defense that is doing damage to the barbarians. So now we are going back to our raid. As you can see, the dragon has gone down, and then now the lava pups has just exploded, and the pups has all just came out to take out some of the buildings, and the wizard tower took out a lot of my pups. So I was quite in a little trouble right now. I was thinking whether I could actually do the 3 star on this base on my first try. So I decided to just persevere on with the healers over there healing the golem itself. I had to take a look at the whole entire surrounding, and I realized that there's only splash damage defenses left, and with a 1 lava pup over there taking out the cannon and the other structures, it was really quick. And then the golem eventually just bust through the wall, getting healed by the healers, not going down too much, because the healers actually do heal back the HP once they are damaged. So eventually the golem just slowly take out the defenses, and then eventually the base got slightly cleared up. And then after that, when all the defenses has gone down, the golem just continued to take out the rest of the structures. So being able to score a 3 star on this single player map using a golem is kind of fortunate, because there's no timer available. There's no 3 minutes timer for any case that the time actually do run out. However, with the golem just running around, just destroying the whole base, is relatively easy in this particular manner. So yeah, the next one was submitted by Alex. Alex, he asked me to use 1 golem, 1 lava hound, 6 balloons, 15 minions, 7 wizards, 6 wall breakers, 6 hawk riders, 3 valkyries, and 12 archers. Also asking me to use air troops for my CC. So in my clan castle, I've given to myself 1 dragon and 1 healer. 1 slot left, left there for nothing. So just deploying my wall breakers first. 6 wall breakers is really useful, breaking up 3 compartments over there, each deploying 1 Valkyrie over there. After that, just continuing the attack with the wizards behind supporting. After that, Hawk Riders I decided to deploy in a different manner, trying to take out the mortars as soon as possible, not going by the back again. And then eventually my Lava Hound has just came out, tanking the damage of the balloons. Balloons gonna go in to try to do some damage onto the defenses. And then eventually I was almost prepared to drop my clan castle, which contained the healer and also the dragon. The healer will aid to heal the golems, and then eventually the dragon will come out to just take care of the rest of the base. That was my plan. So the minions just coming out to support. If you can see, I've also deployed balloons on the left and the right side to take out the wizard towers over there, just deploying 2 balloons separately so that the wizard towers do not take them out quickly. And then eventually just dropping 1 rage spell. Because of this army combo, I was able to use some spells. And then just continue taking out the whole base. The dragon just flying past, going in, taking out the rest of the other structures. So not to worry too much, the dragon is going to survive the whole entire battle. And then eventually just scoring us the 3 stars. So now we are on to the last challenge given by Slippery Fart Box 5. So he asked me to use 1 P.E.K.K.A, 1 Dragon, 6 Giants, 5 Wallbreakers, 5 Wizards, 5 Balloons, 21 Barbarians, 20 Archers, 5 Hawks, 2 Valkyries, and 4 Minions. No heroes, but 1 free spell. Okay, so here we go. So breaking up the walls first using the 5 Wallbreakers. I didn't break the top wall over there because I didn't have enough Wallbreakers. However, 2 compartments being broken up, it should be enough. After that, just deploying my giants in a random fashion. Hopefully, the wizards actually do the damage onto the golems instead of my wizards, because I need the wizards to survive probably half of the battle. And then deploying some of the Valkyries to just do some a bit of the damage again. P.E.K.K.A has already gone in being damaged by the Tesla. So eventually, I decided to deploy some Hawks to try to take out the Mortars on the side. And then now focusing on the center where to drop my spells. So eventually I drop a rage spell and then drop a free spell to try to take out and freeze up some of the defenses, and then eventually dropping the balloon is in the same manner to take out the wizard's towers. And then as you can see, I still have some air troops left, just deploying the balloons in a random manner, and the minions just continue to spam. The dragon has also been deployed on the bottom right, and then eventually just left with lots of ground troops and the wizards over there trying to tank some of the damage. But with the air troops available, it's gonna be a 3-star right now. So yeah, that's it for this particular attack. So for the next one, the next episode, I would like you guys to actually choose my troops again with only 210 spaces now. So do state in the comments what kind of troops you guys would like me to use. You guys can also like tweak it up a bit. Don't have to be a specific like 30 Barbarians, 30 Archers. Could be like 20 Barbarians, 20 Archers to take that in mind too. So hopefully you guys will give more army combos to me, and then I'll do the raids properly again. So with that said, I'd like to wait for your comments and see you guys in the next episode. And thank you to Clash On.